Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. And we are meeting once again with lecture 13 of Business English. Well, today's lecture is going to be a lot of fun. Why? Because you're going to do a lot of work with me. Well, we are going to do a workshop on the things that we have learned together. Well, what are we going to do in the workshop? We are going to talk about resume writing, memo writing, letter writing, email and letter of resignation. Well, what is a workshop? A workshop is a kind of a activity session where students are involved into activities to apply their knowledge, whatever they have learned so far during discussions or class lectures. So I thought that probably before we move on to our course, it's important that I check a little bit of your understanding. So the workshop will have a pattern of for each topic. I'll try to make you go through activities and apply your knowledge on different areas. Let me take you to the very first area that we are going to work on. The very first area that we'll be working on that connects you with the previous lecture, lecture 12, that was about resume writing. So the very first topic is resume writing that we are going to work for. Now, the pattern is going to be that we will do an exercise of vocabulary regarding resume, we will do a reading comprehension, and we will do some functional activity that will be kind of a conversational analysis where you'll be thinking hard and you'll be coming up with your, you know, own answers and own logics behind your analysis and point of view. Okay, so let's start with the very first topic of today's workshop, that is resume writing. And in resume writing, we are going to look at the vocabulary section. Okay, students, so pay focus on the screen. You can look at the screen that there is a table that contains multiple choice questions, and then you have these two indicators in front of each question. One is of wrong and one is of right. Okay, so the instruction you can look at the top of the screen. The sentence below are followed by questions. There are four options for each question. Choose your answer and click it. So you'll be choosing and I'll click it for you. All right, here we go. So these are 15 questions and we will do them one by one. Well, now I want you to be very attentive and pay attention. Okay, please don't forget that this exercise is meant to make you go through your vocabulary storage regarding resume writing. It may not be able to cover everything and all the things, but it may make you to think about your and dig deep in your storage. Okay, the first question is, Ivan sent a copy of his CV to Biscuit Investment. CV stands for? What do you think? CV stands for what? Is it collected volume, curriculum vitae, or current vitals, or corpus voluntarum? If you are saying curriculum vitae, let me check. Here you are. You're right. Okay. Let's go on to the second question. A group of companies in which a person holds shares is called a or an stockbroking, analyst, portfolio, equity listing. What do you think is right? Well, okay, I click on any of it and let's see if we are right. We are right, it's portfolio. Okay, he worked in the field of finance services. Financial services here does not include selling insurance, buying shares, selling pensions, receiving a pensions. Well, what do you think about four of these options? A, B, C, or D? Okay, let me click on D. That's right. Financial services talk about selling, buying shares, insurance, and selling pensions as well, but they do not serve as receivers of the pension. Okay. I'm sorry. All right, so the next question is, he found a new job with another investment company. Another word for job is here, choice, pose, posture, position. What do you say? Choice, no, pose, posture. That is something with body posture, maybe position. Here you are. That's right. Okay. He's a competent spreadsheet user. You find spreadsheets on bank accounts, sailing ships, stock exchanges, or computers. Well, of course, computers. Okay. A society or organization set up for a special purpose may be called an omnivore, clinic, institute, country house. Well, of course, an institute. All right. Average return on investment is 20%. 20% return means amount remaining, profit, percentage, or loss. What do you think? Well, yes, it's profit. Someone you know who can help you is called a informer, contact, rival, dupe. What do you think? Okay, let me click this for you. Contact. Okay. He got straight A grades in his exams. Straight means catastrophic, almost not, honest, without change. Well, straight means maybe without change. That's right. Okay. He worked in the technology sector. The initial means high tech communications are HTNC, IT, BSc, ODH, ODD. It's technology sector. What do you write for that? Simply IT. Right. His marital status is single. This means he is poor, alone, unmarried, or in jail. Well, it's unmarried. Papers which show that you can do a job are called your quantities, academic results, quality control, or qualifications. What do you think about this word, qualifications? There you are, that's right. Okay. The amount of time you have spent doing a job is part of your insurance, experience, certificate, or degree. Job, time that you have spent. Maybe experience. Here you are. Okay. He earns £25,000 plus benefits. Benefits are probably holidays, a sort of pension, additions to a salary, taxes. Taxes he earns. He does not earn taxes. He does not earn a holiday. He does not earn sort of pension. So maybe he earns addition to a salary. Right. Another mostly US name for the head of a company is the OTC, CIC, CEO, or RSE. We discussed it. It's Chief Executive Officer, CEO. Here you are. So you are done with your vocabulary exercise of resume writing. All right, so we are ready to start with our second stage of workshop for resume writing, that is reading comprehension. What I brought for you today is a piece of product from the same genre. It's a resume, and you are going to read the resume, you are going to understand it, and then I'll be asking you a few questions. Okay, look at the screen, please. It's a resume of Ivan T. English. Okay, now look at the, first of all, try to look at the resume. What kind of resume is this? Linear, functional, skill-based, chronological. So identify what kind of resume is this. Okay, now look at the positions held, look at the dates, what kind of positions, in what types of companies, stock analyst, portfolio manager, financial services. Now I hope by now you understand all these terminologies. Look at the qualification section, MBA, honors, and A-levels, straight A's. Look at membership, Institute of Management, British Business Association, relevant experience, competent with Excel spreadsheets. Okay, personal details, marital status, single, driving license, yes, interest, cultivating bonsai trees and cricket, salary, and referees. Okay, now look at the questions, students. The very first question is, Ivan English works, and the four options are, in the IT industry, in financial services, at a Cambridge college, in business management. What do you think? Mark your answer. Okay, second question is, when he left Bellwether Co., he was under 25, over 35, about 30 years, or he doesn't say that at all. Mark your answer. As a portfolio manager, he is totally inexperienced, rather inexperienced, experienced, highly experienced. Mark your answer. Which expression best describes Ivan English? University graduate, IT specialist, director, unskilled labor. Where did Ivan English probably go first? Sydney Sussex College, the Bellwether Co., Borsch Combal and Son, and the Judge Institute. How is Ivan English with regard to share search? Qualified, experienced, practiced, capable. Now you see, we are going through the verbs that we could use to describe our skill or efficiency. What sort of portfolio management can Ivan English do? Only IT, for business, general, those needing informal contacts. What is most significant about the referees given? One is a universal professor, one is a previous employer, they are people who know him well. He does not give his current employers. Okay, before that I discuss answers with you, I want you to have a close look at the CV once again. And this is the first part of the CV that you are seeing on the screen. Look at your questions and mark your answers accordingly. And this is the second part of the CV. Okay. If you feel that I did not give you enough time to look at the CV, what you can do is that when CV is on the screen, you can pause it for a minute and then can answer your questions. I once again show you the questions, the list of questions. You can see first five questions. And you could pause it for a second if you want to. And now you can see next three questions, 6th, 7th, and 8th. I hope you are done by now. Okay, so let me discuss answers with you. Well, Ivan English works. Well, Ivan has worked as a portfolio manager, stock analyst, and financial service manager, all in financial services. So, he uses IT and he went to a Cambridge college. He is a member of Business Institute. Well, so in financial services is the right answer. Alright. Ivan was born in 1968. He left the Bellwether Company in 1997. Therefore, depending on whether he left before or after his birthday on April 7, he was 29 or 30. You look at the process where you are thinking and analyzing. So the right answer is about 30 years old. Now, since he went to Cambridge University, Ivan is a university graduate. He is an IT user, not a specialist. A director has a different job to Ivan's. Unskilled labor means someone who with no qualifications. So your answer is, oh, we have done the fourth one, university graduate. Let's do the third one now. Although he has officially held the position of portfolio manager since 2000, Ivan has been managing portfolios longer than this, since he states that he has portfolio management experience beginning in 1999. So the right answer is experienced. As a portfolio manager, he is experienced. Look at the question number 5. Where did Ivan English probably go first? Well, it is usual for English students to do a general degree at university and then a more specialized one and then to find a job. Therefore, Ivan probably went first to Sydney's Essex College and next to the Judge Institute and then to Bellwether Co. So the right answer is Sydney Sussex College. Now, how is Ivan English with regard to share search? Well, I've been trained with this program, so he's capable. This does not mean he has used it a lot, so he may not be practiced or experienced. He received no qualification after training, so he's not qualified. So the right answer is capable. There's a difference between being capable, qualified, experienced, and practiced. Seventh one is, Ivan says he has broad experience in portfolio management. Although he says that he specializes in IT, he can do another type of portfolio including business. So, the right answer is general. What sort of portfolio management can Ivan do? It's general. The last question of reading comprehension is that, what is most significant about the referees given? Generally, one would expect a current employer to give a reference. Well, Ivan has not done this, perhaps because they would not give a good reference. Either because they are not pleased with him work or because they are angry he is leaving. Or they do not know he plans to leave. So the right answer is he does not give his current employer's reference. Here you go. And you are done with the reading comprehension for resume writing. I hope you would have enjoyed analyzing a resume. Now let's move on to part 3. Okay, let's start our part 3 of the workshop for resume writing, and that's we are dealing with the functions of CV. Well, you have a conversation on the screen, please focus, and it says that your task is that you are a friend of Ivan's And you have heard this conversation between Mr. Blake and Mrs. Meredith. Read it and describe what advice you would give Ivan. When you are finished, we will get into the analysis. Well, there are two characters, Mr. Blake and Mrs. Meredith. Now, let's go through the conversation first, and I do it for you. Well, Mr. Blake, now this young man, English, what do you think of him? Mrs. Meredith, well, I've heard good things about him. Mr. Blake, he's given Ed George as a reference. Can't stand the man myself. Mrs. Meredith, this Professor Doors has a very high reputation, though. How do you, Branch Cumble, feel about this? Don't we do business with them? I don't think they know. We do equity investments with them, but I think they will appreciate a man in our company who knows how they do business. Well, we had better find out, hadn't we? Of course. I'll have a word with Joe Foster. He handles most of our business with Branch Cumball. I'll tell him to put the word out. Well, if Cumball Branch are happy, how do you personally feel? We can still get someone else. Oh, they like him. Young, ambitious, fully trained, and living locally. They think we should go for it. Wait until you hear from Foster. If that's okay, set up an interview. We'll try to start him, say at the end of this next month. All right. So, this was the conversation that you have gone through. Now, what do you think? The question is, read it and decide what advice you would give Ivan. You have to give Ivan some advice. What advice is that? Think about it and you can take a minute for that. All right. So I hope you are done by now and you'll be able to have your advice ready to give it to Ivan. But by the way, how did you analyze that Ivan needs an advice or what kind of advice you should give to Ivan? Well, let me tell you how we can do that. This time I'm going to take you to the conversation once again and we will analyze the conversation sentence by sentence. Okay, look at the very first dialogue. This was, now this young man, English, what do you think of him? It shows that Mr. Black is older and or more senior to Ivan. Well, the way he calls him, a young man. Mrs. Meredith, well, I've heard good things about him. Mrs. Meredith won't give her personal opinion until she knows that Mr. Black thinks, what Mr. Black thinks, but she's positive towards Ivan. You see, I've heard good things about him. Mr. Black, he's given Ed George as a referee. Can't stand the man myself. Mr. Black knows Mr. George very well, since he uses the familiar form of his name. Since Ivan claims to have good informal contacts, he should have known this well. Mrs. Meredith, this professor's door has a very high reputation. Maybe we should see what she thinks. Mrs. Meredith still wants to give Ivan a chance, but she's not going to disagree openly with Mr. Blake. Mr. Blake, how do Branch Campbell feel about this? Don't we do business with them? Well, Mr. Blake is worried about poaching, like taking from someone else's territory, from a friendly company, and that this might damage business relations. Mrs. Meredith says that, I don't think they know. We do equity investments with them, but I think they will appreciate a man in our company who knows how they do business. Mrs. Meredith thinks that both companies would benefit from having someone who can act as a link between them. This is in Ivan's favor. Well, Mr. Black says that, well, we had better find out, hadn't we? This is rather rude. Mr. Black does not like Mrs. Meredith supporting Ivan so strongly when he's not sure. He wants to see if Branch Campbell agreed to losing this employee. If Ivan has not told his boss what he's planning, he will have a problem. This does not worry Mr. Black. Well, Mrs. Meredith, on the other hand, says, of course, I'll have a word with Joe Foster. He handles most of our business with Branch Campbell. I'll tell him to put the word out. Now, what does it mean? It means that Mrs. Meredith is not going to help Ivan if it offends Mr. Blake. She tells him she will arrange for Campbell Branch to be contacted informally. Well, Mr. Blake, well, if Campbell Branch are really happy now, do personal feel we can still get someone else? Mr. Blake is satisfied. He has got his way. He has no personal problems with Ivan and is satisfied with the rest of his CV. He's now saying that if personnel agree, he will too. What it means that Mr. Black is satisfied he has got his way. He has no personal problems with Ivan and is satisfied with the rest of his CV. He's now saying that if personnel agree, he will too. Mr. Meredith says, oh, they like him. Young, ambitious, all the adjectives, and then they think we should go for it. And again, Mrs. Meredith is not giving her opinion, but she's very happy to give someone else positive opinion. Mr. Black, wait until you hear from Foster. If that's okay, set up an interview and we'll try to start him, say at the end of next month. The interview should be a formality. Whether or not Ivan gets the job will depend on how strongly Campbell Burrush feel about his leaving. Well, now this was the sentence by sentence analysis of the conversation, and that is how I want you to analyze whenever you listen to one conversation, and that is business specific conversation. Now, moving back to the question that we needed to know, you need to remember that this analysis is particularly true about British language and culture. And though mostly it is the same for other English-speaking countries like Australia, United States, or now even the even all the developing countries where English is used as official language, so the cultural attitudes are always there to give meanings a little different shade. So be careful and sensitive to cultural differences. If Ivan has not told Brosh Campbell that he is leaving, he must do it now. Before Mr. Foster tells them. So you can tell Ivan that he has probably got the job, but only if Brush Campbell, do not object to him working for Mr. Black's company. If Brush Campbell do object, Ivan will not get the job. So you can also tell Ivan that Mrs. Meredith supports him, but she will not do anything to upset Mr. Black. Mr. Black is not an easy man to work for, because he does not like people arguing with him, and he is not very considerate. Also tell Ivan that putting Mr. George as a referee was a bad mistake. Fortunately, this has not caused a big problem, but he should be very careful about this in the interview. If he doesn't make any mistake in the interview, he will probably get the job. So that was the case that we analyzed. All right, let's start with our second topic of the workshop, that is letter writing. After resume writing, we are going into letter writing, and for letter writing we will start with informal letters. And again, the pattern will be same. We will do a vocabulary exercise, we will get into some reading comprehension, and we will do some analytical activity too. All right, so let's start with our very first activity, that is vocabulary exercise. Again, you have multiple choice questions, and I want you to pay attention and tell me, an office where everyone works in the same room is called Chinese walled, flat packed, open plan, or downsized? What do you think? It's an open plan. All right, what is ASDL? It's EU business legislation, or a pension plan, or a bad manager, or a fast internet connection. ASDL. Well, you're right, it's a fast internet connection. Information that updates as it happens is called fast ticker info, the grapevine, relative information, or real-time information. Very good. Real-time information. Okay. When different people take turns using the same desk, this is called timeshare, capacity utilization, table swapping, or hot desk, hot desking. Hot desking. Okay. Furniture that is comfortable and designed to work with your body is called massage furniture, body wise, agronomic, or RCI inducing. That probably is something new for you, so let me help out. It's ergonomic. Ergonomic furniture is basically designed to work with your body that is comfortable. Which expression means a working day? Well, 9 to 5, TGIF, milestone, or daily dollar? 9 to 5. Okay, a place to park your car is car station, parking bay, car pound, or two-way zone. What do you think? Very right, it's parking bay. An idiomatic expression for my car is my mojo, my gate boat, my getabout, my puncture, my wheels. Okay, if you can choose some of the hours you work, this is called clock watching, clocking in, non-standard time, or flexi time. A flat hierarchy means that there aren't any managers, promotion is slow, no one works hard, profits are low, there aren't many managers. What does the colloquial expression head honcho means? A good job, the boss, a bad feeling, or a pocket calculator? The boss, head honcho. If you get some money for joining a company, this is called a hot trip, golden hello, welcome in, boarding pass. What do you think about golden hello? Okay, now EWYK means you are paid for the business you create for your company. Extra work you seek, earning your work, each week you know, or eat what you like, eat what you kill, eat what you kill. Okay, companies being launched on the stock exchange are called IPOs. What does IPO stand for? Well, initially proven options, initial public offering, in profit organization, ideal profit opportunities. Well, initial public offering. People who invest and develop new companies are called shareholders, stockbrokers, venture capitalist, or estate agents. It's venture capitalist. Okay, this was your vocabulary drill for the exercise related to informal letters workshop. All right, let's start with our second stage of the workshop of the based on the informal letters. And here I have a sample of the genre for your analysis. You can see a letter on the screen. Please pay close attention. Here you are. You can look at the greeting, the salutation. I guess salutation is quite enough to tell you that it's an informal letter. Look at the paragraphing. Look at the formatting. And then you are ready to read the text. Hi, Jack. You wanted to know what things were like at my new job. Well, for a start, let me tell you about the office. It's open plan, but that does not mean a lot because there are only there three of us in it. All right, open plan. Our workstations are arranged in a sort of island in the middle of the room, and there is a computer with an ASDL connection in the corner. This is really useful because it gives us real-time information on the stocks we are following. Unfortunately, there is only the one, so we are hard desking on it. The chairs are swivel and tilt. I never realized how important it is to have ergonomic chairs until I started doing my 9 to 5s in one. The main perk for me is that I have my own parking bay in the underground garage, so I don't have to worry where to put my wheels during the day. We work flexi time, though there is a core time of 10 to 2 when we all have to be there. The hierarchy is pretty flat. We report directly to Magnus Black, who is the head hunko here. I don't know what sort of package the others have. I got a small golden hello, and there is a good basic salary. Though anything extra is EWIK. Anyway, I am researching a new portfolio for a single client. He wants a higher return than I'm going to get from blue stock chips. So I'm looking for some promising IPOs that can give our 8%. Can you put the word out with some of the venture capitalists you play golf with every Wednesday? We'll exchange notes at the gym on Friday. Ivan. It's such a business letter. No, it is informal in tone, but look at the vocabulary and terminology used inside. So even if you're writing informal to a business, a contact, you are using business terms. All right, here you are. So you have questions to answer. So look at the questions on the screen. The main purpose of the email is to, and you have four options, give information, ask for information, both A and B, say hello to Jake. Well, mark your answer. The tone of the email is business-like, informal, detailed, restrained. Okay. Why does Ivan mention chairs? He often changes desk. He likes tilting them. He spends all day sitting. They were better in his last job. How does Ivan get to work? By car? On a bicycle? On the underground? He doesn't say that. All right. What is implied about blue chip stocks? They are not profitable enough, or they are safe, or they are new, or they are Jack's speciality. What does Ivan want from Jake? To meet a venture capitalist? To make an IPO? To get some good tips or a conversation about golf? Do Jake and Ivan go to the same gym regularly? Most probably, probably not, certainly not. And I take you to the email once again, a letter once again. You can have a look at it and can see if you are left with any of the answers. Okay, I hope by now you are ready to mark your answers and you are done with that. Let me share the answers with you. Well, I would like to share these answers with you with some kind of thought related, logic related behind that. So the first question is, the main purpose of the email is to, Ivan is writing to give his friend Jake information about his new job. Because Jake has asked him to do this, but Ivan also wants Jake to give him some information about companies to invest in. Ivan does say hello to Jake, but that is not his main reason for writing. It is possible that his main reason is that he wants information, but he's careful not to make that obvious. So the answer is both A and B for the first question. Well, for second question, the tone of the email is informal. That is very obvious. Ivan uses casual salutations and colloquial language, my wheels, head honcho, and there is no reason to say that it is restrained and it is certainly not businesslike, nor is it particularly detailed. So the informal is the right answer for question number two. Look at question number three. Why does Ivan mention chairs? Well, Ivan spends all his day in front of a computer screen. Therefore, it is very important to him that the chairs he sits in are comfortable and that they support his spine correctly. Ivan says he only realized this after he got a job where he spends a lot of time sitting. So, the right answer is C for question 3. Question 4, how does Ivan get to work? Well, we know that Ivan gets to work by car because having a place to park is very important to him, and he says that that is where his car is parking during the day. So the right answer for question number 4 is A. Blue chip stocks, question number 5 is, what does Ivan say about his salary? Well, Ivan does not directly give any opinion about this, his salary, but he says that the basic salary is good because it is bad manners in England to boast about your salary, though you are allowed to complain. We can infer that Ivan is satisfied. We know he does not know the salaries, remuneration package of the others. He does get extra money from commission. So the right answer for question number 5 is B. Okay. Achha, jab main ye answers discuss kar rahi hoon, to aapne screen nahi dikhani hai. Aapne sirf discussion dikhani hai. Sirf jab main answers discuss kar rahi hoon. Is analysis ke part 3 ke. Okay, now question number 6. What is implied about blue chip stocks? What do you think? Well, blue chip stocks are usually safe, but Ivan does not mention this. But what he does say is that he needs something that is more profitable, and there is no mention that these are Jack's specialty, and no reason to infer this as well. So the right answer for question number 6 is A. They are not profitable enough. Seventh question is, what does Ivan want from Jake? To meet a venture capitalist, to make an IPO, to get some good tips, or a conversation about golf? Well, Ivan does not want to meet a venture capitalist. What he wants is Jack to talk to some and get some useful information about that will help Ivan to decide what stocks he wants to buy. Venture capitalists often promote new companies. So the right answer is C for question number 7. For question number 8, do Jake and Ivan go to the same gym regularly? Well, it is very probably that Ivan and Jake go regularly to the same gym because Ivan does not need to say which gym. And he does not need to ask whether Jake will be there. So the right answer is A, most probably. And here we are done with the second part of our second stage of a workshop, that was informal writing. And in the next part, we will do the functional aspect of letter writing. All right, let's start with our third and final step for informal letters workshop, that is a functional analysis. So, look at this conversation between two people, Jake and Vernold. Jake is playing golf with venture capitalist Vernold, and you're going to listen to this conversation and read it as well, and you will try to decide on the first question is that the relationship between the two men, what kind of relationship is that? And question number B is that what else is happening in the conversation? When you have decided, then we can discuss the answers. Now look at the conversation, and I'm going to read it for you as well, or rather I'm going to perform it for you. Jake: oh dear Walnut, bad luck. What are you thinking about? Obviously not golf. Is your mind still on business? Walnut: why? Are you finishing for some information? Are you fishing for some information? Walnut: anything in particular? Jack laughs. Always. And Walnut: anything in particular? Jack: well, yes, actually, I have this friend, Ivan English. Do you know him? And he's looking to build a portfolio of hot new stocks. Walnut: English? No, I don't know him. Would he be interested in health services? Jake: I must introduce you one day. You'll like him. I would think so. He's an IT specialist, but he covers the whole market. Walnut: well, tell him to look at Loshile. They are going to sell off their non-healthcare business and stick to their core competence. I think the market will like that. Jake: Loshile? Ah, okay. I'll make a note. Walnut: and if he's interested in IT, I hope he's following Bartek. Word is they are going to be taken over soon. Jake: oh, really? Who's the buyer? Walnut: never you mind. Now, of course, I am bringing Clariton Toys to market soon. Ah, yes. Clariton, I'll tell Ivan to check out the stock carefully. Do you have a prospectus I could send him? I'd be delighted. It's worth a punt, you know. All right. So your two questions to think about are: what is the relationship between these two fellows? And what else is happening in the conversation? Okay, take a minute and think about it. All right, let's go for our analysis. And first we will do the analysis step by step, sentence by sentence. Oh dear, Walnut, bad luck. Well, here Jack is using a bad shot by Walnut to steer the conversation delicately toward business. Well, Walnut: are you fishing for something? Walnut is still angry about his bad shot and answers very directly with a challenge. Jack laughs. Jack admits that he is fishing for information and now gives Walnut the choice of whether to give him something or not directly. And Walnut: anything in particular? Walnut is ready to do Jake the favor. And Jake explains he wants a favor from Walnut as a favor to Ivan. And Walnut wants to know if his information on health service is good enough. Here we are talking about Ivan. And Walnut says that he wants to know if this information on health service is good enough for him, and Jake says it is not perfect, but it will do. And he also suggests that Ivan may like to repay Werner's favor directly instead of through Jake. And notice how the conversation is now about two different topics at the same time, Ivan and heart shares. Werner's offers some information he knows is valuable. He uses suspect rather than know, because Ivan can buy shares on someone's opinion, but it is illegal to act on insider information. Well, Jack keeps his reply short, hoping for more. Word is Vernal's way of saying this time he really is reporting a rumor? Well, Jack is very interested, this time for himself. Vernald has said enough. Information about the buyer is too sensitive for him to give away, and he says this clearly. He also feels he must promote a company he's working with, but his style shows that he knows it's not a very good stock. Well, Jack shows he's not enthusiastic about Claritin either, but he says he will let Ivan decide for himself. He uses the word carefully to show that he will not try to deceive Ivan, but he will do Vernon the favor of drawing Ivan's attention to the company. And Vernon has done his duty both for Jake and for Claritin. It is now up to Jake whether they discuss more business or get back to golf. So, the answers to the questions are, Jake and Vernon meet regularly for golf and to exchange information and favors. In this case, Jake wants a favor for Ivan. And he also thinks that Ivan and Vernon might be useful for each other. Vernon offers some useful information, but nothing major. He tries to get Jake entrusted in one of his own companies. Jake entrusted in one of his own companies because he thinks he should. But he knows Jake and Ivan will not be really interested in Claritin. Jake and Vernon are friendly, but not friends. Each of them is useful to the other, and the golf gives them an excuse to exchange information, as well as being something they enjoy. All right. So this was the analysis of our informal letter topic of the workshop. Well, this brings us to the end of the talk. And in today's talk, what we did basically, we had a workshop where we went through the vocabulary, reading comprehension, and functional analysis regarding two topics. One is one was the resume writing, and other was an informal letter. And while doing it, you came across one thing that I would ask you to remember regarding this analysis is particularly in, and these analyses that we are doing, they are particularly language and cultural restricted. And we are talking about the native speakers because we are dealing with the medium that is English. However, although the world is when it has turned into a global village, the cultures are merging. And no culture is entirely different from the other. All cultures keep something same with the other. So when the language we adopt the language, we use the language officially, we use English language officially in Pakistan, we cannot really avoid the culture. So culture has become part of our own culture. No, definitely we have not adopted everything, and we have adapted a few things as well, but things are still there, moods are there, because people have learned it and they are educated. They do have this English language as their thinking language now. Many of them are working for English as not as their second language, but more in between first and second language. So we cannot really copy the cultures, but we can use information wisely. So whenever you are analyzing information, you are dealing with people in business who are dealing in English, you need to understand the cultural differences and the mood of the language that they are into, and always make your decision wisely. Second important thing that I would want to say here is that whenever you are analyzing one conversation, whether you are doing it spontaneously at the spur of the moment, or you listen to something, you go home and you think, always try to be logical. Do not let your assumptions and emotionally affected interpretations intervene so much. Try to be logical and try to assume things that are not negative. Try to be positive. However, if you have interpretations that show you one side that is not really bright, you can always get clear about that side. So this was all about today's talk, and this was lecture 13. So what we did in lecture 13, we had our hands-on experience. You remember I used this word in lecture 12 or lecture 11, having hands-on experience on something. We had our hands-on experience on resume writing situations and formal writing, informal letter writing situations. I wanted to cover more, but since this was the beginning of the workshop, we may have more of these workshops during our course, so you can have a real-life linked experience experience of these things, and you're not only having a documentation knowledge, but how you can practically apply and have the application of this knowledge in the world outside. So this was all for today's talk. Inshallah, I will see you in the next lecture. That is going to be our lecture 14. Allah Hafiz.